are individual sub-assemblies. Okay, an assembly can be made up of individual parts, or also it can be made up of individual sub-assemblies. Say for example, if you are designing a car, the entire system, a car is a product and it is an assembly. But when you break this down, we'll be getting transmission system, engine, and then electrical systems, door panels, back door, side doors, etc. Each one of this is going to be sub-assemblies. When you take a side door itself, there will be a door structure, chassis structure, as well as there will be glasses and glass controlling mechanisms, electrical wires, cables, harness, everything will be there within the door system itself. So each one of this is considered as a sub-assemblies. And combining all these sub-assemblies together, you will get a car. Okay, so just like that, assembly can be a single part or it can be individual sub-assemblies. Hope you understand. Those sub-assemblies can be even further break down into either a part or sub-assemblies. Okay, because everything, each and everything in the car is not just a part, it is going to be group of components, product. Okay, or any other, not just car. Any component, machines, SPMs or hydraulic machines, automobile machines, or even aircrafts, everything. So right now I have created a part in the assembly, as you can see. So first one represents, the yellow color represents it is a part. This first icon represents it is a part. F represents, there is a F symbol that represents the part is fixed and the part name. Okay. I will explain these terminologies once again once I created the component, because and that time only it will be meaningful. So let me select this part, go for edit component. Right now I'm in assembly, I'm trying to edit a part. When you select edit component, you will be in a part design. There is two environment here. One is the assembly environment, where you will be seeing assembly tabs here. Closely take a look here. There is an assembly tab, layout, sketch. I hope it is visible to everyone. So assembly tab, the option that is required to do an assembly. Layout, okay, to create an entire assembly. Layout needed to be created using sketch, evaluate, etc. Kindly note, there is no features tab. Features tab is used to create a 3D model. Okay, there is no features tab yet. But when you try to edit a component, you'll have the features tab. When you try to edit the component, you'll have features tab. There is no more assembly tab. Okay, that means we are switching from assembly environment into part environment. Part environment is where you can create the part. In assembly environment, you cannot create something. You can only assemble something. Okay. So right now I'm in a part environment. Within assembly, I'm trying to create a component. Then we will try to assemble it. So as I told you before, so it is a flange. You can see the cross section of the flange, how it looks like. So now let me draw the shape that is required. we can provide the dimension that is required for this. So let me just create it. Provide all the dimensions that is required. So just like that, I have given all the dimensions that is required to create the flange, and you can use revolve. Okay, previously we seen extrude everything. Now we are going to see revolve. So go for the revolve. You can create the cylindrical shape. Just flange. Okay. So SolidWorks also provides hole dart, which can be used to create different standard holes. You can see hole wizard, just select that. The left hand side, you can see counter board hole, countersunk, normal hole, and different standard ANSI metric inch. You can see all the standards here. Different type of holes, different standards. Let me select ISO, normal hole. Let me change this to tab drill, and you can select what are the sizing. Okay, so let me select 1/16 in wherever you want to place the hole. Go for the position, select this face, place it here, and you can provide the distance between these two. From this point to this point, what are the distance? You can provide the distance at 60, so that PCD will be 20. So I have created a hole. Just give OK. The hole will be created. So once the hole is created, if you want to change the dimension, as you can see, it is very less now. If you want to change the dimension also, it is possible. You'll be able to edit it at later point. Go for the edit feature, and you can change it to M16 to M20 or something. You can change it M22 also. Just click OK. So once you have created the hole, as I told you before, you can create duplicates using circular pattern. So you can create number of duplicates. First, select the feature hole wizard. Select this cylindrical face, and you will create number of holes. Let me go for 6. Just give OK. So I have created a single component in order to create a coupling. Okay. So this is one half. We also need another half. We just need another component just like this in order to assemble. To do that, you can just press Control and click and drag to create a duplicate. Press Control and click and drag. You'll be able to create duplicate. Just press Control and click and drag. You'll be able to create number of duplicates. It is just a shortcut. So once you've created a single component, if you have multiple components, you can just copy paste it. You can use Control C, Control V, or else you can use Control and click and drag. The component will be copied and pasted. Okay. So hope this is clear.
Okay, I was regarding for.
Hello, sir. The voice is breaking. Hello, sir. Is it clear? Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for your response. Most of us know that when we are having a component in a real world also, we are having 6 degrees of freedom. Okay, when you are having a component, that it will have 6 degrees of freedom, 3 translation and 3 rotation about the axes. So just like that, in here also, these component is going to have 6 degrees of freedom. So as I said before, in the left hand side feature manager, there is something called F. Previously, I hope you might have noted this, the F symbol and minus symbol. Okay, that is, this is also very important. That's why I'm explaining. F represents, it is a fixed component. If you arrest all 6 degrees of freedom using fix option, if you right click, you can find the fix. When you right click on a component, you can find a fix option. When you provide fix, the component cannot be moved anywhere else. It cannot be rotated or it cannot be moved. Okay, so here you can see when you provide fix, it will be F. If it is float, which means it can be moved anywhere. Okay, and if you provide proper constraint, then it will not have any symbols. So one component, the first component is fixed. The second component is free to move. Okay, please do understand, in your assembly, any one of the component has to be properly fixed. Okay, at least any one of the component has to be fixed. Do not fix more than one component. Okay, at least one component has to be fixed. Do not fix more than one, which means the first component, the base component, has to be fixed. The other components should not be fixed. Okay, I will explain it once again when we are going for other type of assembly. So right now it can be moved everywhere. This cannot be moved since it is fixed. So in order to assemble this, perform mate. In solid, in 2D sketch, we have seen it as a relations. Here it is called mates. Okay. So mates is nothing but making sure this component properly fits together. Providing constraints, providing relations between two phases. Say for example, if these two phases are going to be coincide, okay, they are going to share the same area. So here you can see it is coincide, but it needs to be on the opposite direction. Okay, it is, they both are in the same direction. We want that to be in the opposite direction. So to do that, you can use this symbol, flip mate alignment. You can use this to flip. You can see the difference. You can use this to slip, or else you can use this to flip here. They both are the same. This is just a fly toolbar. This is the proper toolbar, mate alignment. You can use this to align it. Okay, hope this is clear. So now this is in the proper direction. They both are in the same place. Just give OK. Now it is coincident. It can only move in this planar face. We both know, we know that this has to be coincide, concentric. This cylinder has to be in the same line of action. So here you can see, they both has to be same line of action. So I think now you might have see that. I think there is a lag in videos. Let me show you. Let me explain this once again, duplicating the component. I got a comment to explain duplicating the component. I'll explain it. If you want to duplicate it, press Control. Press Control, click the component and drag it outside. Just press Control, click the component and drag it outside. You can see the duplicate. Just like that, you can create duplicate. Okay. So, or else you can press Control C, Control V, copy paste, just like you will do in a Word document or any other documents. Select this on the left hand side tree, Control C. Select the assembly, Control V. If you press number of times, you can see it is duplicated, but it has to be dragged out. It needs to be dragged out. That is the difference. Hope you understand this. So let me show once again how you can provide the mates. Mates is nothing but providing relations, providing constraints between these two components. So now go for the mate, select these two phases, and that will be in the same area, coincidence, like they will be stick together. It has to be in the opposite direction. Flip the mate alignment. If you do that, the component will be flipped to the other direction. Once you have done the coincidence, the cylindrical face has to be in the same line of action. then only the holes that we are providing, the nuts and bolts will be properly positioned. So you can select those to provide concentricity. You can see what are the relations here: coincidence, parallel, perpendicular, tangency, concentricity. Each one of these mates are given based on the selection of the face. If it is a two planar faces, you can provide distance between them, parallel, perpendicular, coincidence. You cannot provide concentricity because it is planar faces. When you select two cylindrical faces, you can provide parallel, perpendicular, tangency, and concentricity. You cannot provide coincidence. So likewise, based on the selection, whether it is a planar face or cylindrical face, both of them, you will be able to select only few of these mates, not all of them. Okay, so let me provide concentricity. Just give okay. Now here you can see the component is still rotating. I told you there are 6 degrees of freedom. I have arrested up to 5 degrees of freedom. Only 1 degree of freedom is free. Here you can see the component is still rotating. In order to arrest that also, go for the mates, select this cylindrical face and select this cylindrical face. They both has to be properly coincide, concentric. If they are concentric only, we will be able to insert nut as well as bolt. Okay, so provide concentric. So here you can see it is properly assembled. If you see, if you take a look at the branch, here you can see there is no symbol. Previously there was a minus symbol, right now there is no symbol. Hope it is clear to everyone. So likewise, you can create a component, you can assemble it in the assembly itself. Okay, this is top down approach. Let me add nuts and bolts also. SolidWorks provides a design library where you can access all the toolbox, nuts, bolts, fasteners, gears. Based on different standards, you will be able to get. Here you can see there are different standards are here. When you move into it, you can see nut, bolt, fasteners, keys, pins, structural members, power transmissions, washers, everything can be obtained. Okay, so now for this particular hole, go for the smart holes, smart fasteners, select this cylindrical face, add, select this cylindrical face, provide add. It will create socket based on the dimension. Okay, so you can change it if you want. It was a M22 for this particular type of component. There is no M22, so let me change a different type of socket, a different type of bolt. Instead of socket, you can select different type of hole series. Change fasteners type. You can select whether you want a hexa bolt, structural steel, or bolt screw, and select all this type, whether you want a hexagonal socket. So I will go with hexa bolt structural. Just give okay. So here you can see different sizes are available here. So now you can also add fasteners, nuts, bolts. So let me add one more time. Go for the smart fasteners. Select this cylindrical face. Go for add. You can change the fasteners type. You can add nut, bolt, etc. So here, if you want, you can add a washer on the top. You can add a washer on the top. Just select washer. Here you can see the washer is added. And also in the bottom, I need a washer. Then here you can see the washer is added. I need a bolt. You can select, and sorry, I need a nut. You can select a nut, extra flange nut or extra nut. So select the component, whatever you want. The entire system, things, nut, bolt, fastener, everything can be just added in a single shot. So this is one way that you can use this option. You can create the component, you can assemble it in here, as well as you can add nuts, bolts, fasteners, etc. Hope this is clear. And the last thing is checking the interference. Okay, like when you assemble something, we need to know whether it is properly fitted or not. If it is not properly fit, then there will be some problem when we are going for manufacturing. Okay, so if the tolerance is not right, if a component is not fit properly, then we'll be facing problem during our manufacturing. So to check that, you can do interference detection. Go for interference detection, calculate, and you can see how much interference is there. Okay, so we are having interference between nut and bolt, not between components. We are having interference between nut and bolt. There are totally 6 nut, so we are having 12 interference. Okay, so the thing here is that when we are creating this nut and bolt, there will be mesh between the threads, right? So that's what the interference is. Okay, we don't have the threads here, so basically there will be small interference between these components, but there is no interference between the components. Okay, so you can check this interference and you can remove the interferences. If you have any interference, you can remove it. So this is top down approach. Okay, entering into an assembly, you can create all kind of thing. The one advantage is that when we are doing some research work, okay, we wouldn't be having a proper dimension for the component. So at that time, developing component based on other component will be very easy in this kind of approach, top-down approach. When you're going for bottom up, you need to have proper dimension for each components. Okay, then only you'll be able to create it separately. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you to create using bottom up. So that is the basic difference. If it is an initial stage development, creating it in top-down approach will be very useful as well as advantages. But the other disadvantage of top-down approach is that if you are having components more than 10-20, if you are having large assemblies such as car and machine, you need to be more careful with the references. Okay, where you are creating, where you are providing coincidence references, those things you need to create, you need to have more attention towards that. Sometimes it will be very blur to see how it is referenced with other components. So let me show you another approach, bottom up approach. So let me say this is a flange coupling.
Thank you.
So let me show you this. Just give me a minute. I'll just the component is not opening. Just give me a minute. I'll just share it. Share in a minute. So let me show you how you can do bottom up approach. So go for the assembly. We need to have the components that needs to be created before. Okay, first we need to have the components. We are going to create this vibration assembly. When you open a new assembly environment, it will ask for you to browse. Okay, so wherever you have saved those components, you have to find that, and you can see all the components that we have created will be listed here. So base isolator, it is actually an isolation system which is used to reduce the vibration of a component. So you might be seeing one of this kind under a large pumps or a vibrating structures. So the first component is vibrator and isolator. So that will be our base. Then we need to insert the spring. Go for insert components. Insert the spring. You can place the spring over top of this. Okay. So here you can see the component can be anywhere. So go for the mate. And this component has to be placed on top of this. This has to be placed on top of this. And this spring has to be properly positioned at the center. Okay, I'll just show it in the top view. This position and this component has to be properly positioned at the center. In order to do that, you can select this cylindrical face, outside cylindrical face, and the axis for this spring. There is an axis. Select both of them. This will be properly at the center. So likewise, either you can select mates between planes, lines, phases, as well as points. So I have selected the bottom. So just like that, you can create, you can just copy paste and another component, duplicate. Just drag and drop. Let me rotate it, rotate the component. Go for the mate, select this top face and select this top. So this will be coincide. Coincide is making sure those two faces stick together. Okay, as well as concentric, the center axis of this cylindrical face as well as center axis of the spring, they both will be coincide. Properly position. And also in order to make sure the top and bottom bolted together, you can select this cylindrical face and you can select this. Select both of them. Just give OK. So likewise, you can insert another component into the assembly environment. You can just import number of components. You can just assemble it together. The left hand side, you can see the spring. And I just zoom in the left hand side, you'll be able to identify. Except the spring, both bases are fully fixed. Spring is having minus symbol. That's because it is having motion and rotation about the center. It can be rotated. Okay. So likewise, when you are having any component that will be rotated, you have to leave the component free. If you arrest the rotation, it will not exactly work as it would do in a real-time environment. So when you are assembling the component, you have to consider how the components will be behaving in a real-time environment. Okay. Not just how it will be attached, we also need to consider how the components will be behaved. Okay, so let me show you another example, machine-wise assembly. Machine-wise. So here you can see, I have all the components. Let me show you. So each one of this is a individual components. Here you can see the pin. So each one of this is the individual components. So when we have individual components, you can bring all into it, then you can start assemble it. This is the jaw, moving jaw, pin, everything is there. So first go for the mate. You can select this cylindrical faces and this cylindrical face in order to align it properly. Just give OK. And this pin, this has to be inserted inside. So select this cylindrical face as well as this outer cylindrical face. If the components are hidden inside of another component, you can make the component hide. So hiding the component, showing it, everything can be done here. Hide the component, you can move it a little bit outside. Make sure it is shown back. You can provide tangency between these two components. Mate, select this cylindrical face, select this flat face. It will be tangent. Just like that, you can select the top face, cylindrical face, and select this top face. It will be tangent. When I create a section view of this, you'll find it properly positioned. Here you can see it is properly positioned. So now you can insert the entire assembly. The entire assembly inside of this base. So go for mate. Here you can see this edge will be screwed. So select these two faces. It will be concentric. select these two faces, this will be parallel. Okay, if it is parallel, it can only move in topward, top and down direction. It cannot rotate. Then we need this component lever to be inserted inside. So you can select this, you can select the cylindrical area. It will be inside. So here you can see it can be rotated. Make sure it is at the center. Okay. So in order to do that, in order to make sure it is at the center, we can select this lever component. Each one of these component is going to have different planes, front plane, top plane, side plane. You can make sure these planes are properly assembled. Can make sure these two are properly coincide so that it will be at the center. Once it is at the center, you can assemble this hand onto that. Go for the mate. Select concentric to these two faces and make sure these edges are coincide. So I have only one side. In assembly also, you can mirror the components. Not just in the part, in assembly also, you can just mirror the component from one side to the other side. So to do that, you can go for the mirror component, select the center plane, select this component. This will be on the other direction. So here you can see it is on the other direction. The same manner, you can go for the mirror component once again, select the center plane, select this component, because this pin also needs to be on the other direction. The pin we have entered, it needs to be on the other direction. Let me show you in the sectional view. The pin that we have entered, this is on here. This needs to be on the other direction. So go for the mirror, select the vertical direction, select this particular component, go to next. Here you can see the preview on a purple color. Just give okay, the component will be inserted. So likewise, duplicating the component and mirroring the component is also very easy. And you can see how the components is moving. In order to replicate a real-time environment, okay, we know that this component has to be moving in this particular area, but it should not intersect like this. In order to see those things, we have option called interference detection and collision detection. So go for the mate. Move component, make sure collision detection is on, stop at collision. If you move this, okay, when you have an interest as collision, it will pop up this window and it will show you the component is being colliding. Okay, and we also have other advanced mates which can be used to limit the distance, because if it is coincide, it can be moved anywhere it want. Okay. So in order to limit the distance, you can go for the mate. You can select the top face. In these faces, provide the distance limit mate in the advanced mate. So let me show you here. The advanced mate, we have option called the limit mate. Go for advanced mate. First, the limit distance, go for it. You can provide the distance as 80 on the maximum distance, minimum distance as 0. So when you do that, the component so this component can move up to 80, but it cannot move after the 0. Okay, it can move up to only 80 only. This can be moved, dragged down to 80. This cannot move up to the touching faces. It cannot move beyond that. So likewise, you can control. Previously, you could see it's moving top and bottom as well. Now it is constrained within the limit. Okay. So likewise, you can provide some advanced maze as well as some advanced options in order to replicate the real-time enrollment scenarios. Okay. Sometimes we will be need to some component needs to be followed a path. For that, we can provide follow.
Yeah.
Path made likewise. Hello. Sir, kindly mute yourself, sir.
கொஞ்சம் காஃபி கிடைக்குமா?
ஹலோ சார்.
எக்ஸ்கியூஸ் மீ சார்.
சார் கைண்ட்லி ஹலோ
சேனிங்
எக்ஸ்கியூஸ் மீ சார்.
எஸ் எஸ் மேடம் மேடம் சோ சைடுல நாய்ஸ்
கூண்டலாம் வாங்கிட்டேன் கொஞ்சம்
Yes sir, there is some crosstalk. Participants, please mute your Participants, please mute yourself.
உள்ள இருக்கானா? காணோம்.
சார், யோகானந்த் ஜெயராஜ் ஜெயராமன். யோகானந்த் ஜெயராமன், ப்ளீஸ் மியூட் யுவர் ஆடியோ.
தேங்க் யூ சார். சோ கமிங் பேக் டு தட், இன் ஆர்டர் டு கிரியேட் ரியல் டைம் சினாரியோஸ் வி கேன் ப்ரொவைட் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் மேட்ஸ். Different relations can also be given here. So the another scenario here is that the surface on this cylinder as well as inside of this will be having screws in order to move this component up and down. We'll be having screws, so threads will be there. So to replicate those threads, we have mechanical mates. You can use these mechanical mates in order to replicate the screw motion. So gear motions, rack and pinion, screw, universal joint, these kind of mechanical mates can also be given. In the screw mates, go for the screw mate. You can provide per how many revolutions it is needed, per revolution how much distance is required. So let me provide for distance. For revolution, it's going to be some 5 mm movement in the axis direction. So select these two things and just give OK. So by doing so, what will happen is that when I try to move this, the component is going to, when I create a one single rotation, this component is going to move 5 mm. So limit distance weight is given. Okay, component. Let me reverse the direction for the limit distance made. Let's give OK. This. So now you can rotate, just rotate this. For this, I will change the plane for that. Now this will be able to rotate. Yes. So when we rotate this, it's going to be moved in the vertical direction. So let me show you that. So here you can see when I rotate, it's just rotating on it. We can also provide some motors to do that. After creating this, if provide some motors, it is going to move up and down. We can also create kinematic simulations. We can see how the component is actually create moving, how it is going to work. You can do all these things in an assembly. So let me quickly provide a motor. You can go for the motion study where you can create these kinematic things. Go for the motor here. Select this cylindrical surface. You can provide the speed, okay, or how many revolutions that is required, those kind of things. So provide 100 RPM. It is going to solve for nearly 5 seconds. Just give okay and animate it. So you can see how it is rotating now. So let me play from the start. So like this, you can make the component to move the downward direction, or also you can reverse the motor the opposite direction. Just give okay. So let me move it to 10 seconds. So it is going down right now. When it reaches 5 seconds, the motor will be off and it will come back to its original position. So like I said, you can create both downward motion as well as upward motion. So it's not just this screw motion. You can create entire structure. If it's an engine, you can create the entire components, assemble them together. If you try to rotate this crankshaft, the connecting rod and the piston, everything will be rotated. It depends upon the crankshaft. Okay. And also the based on the constraints that we have given. If you have given any wrong constraints, so there will be some problem. Just a few minutes before, I faced one. Like I gave coincidence to the center plane, the pink color plane, sorry, the purple color plane that is showing right now. So because of that only, I was not able to rotate it. Once I suppressed it, I was able to rotate the component. So you have to create the real-time conditions. It has to be in a proper dimension, and it has to be properly assembled to match the real-time conditions. If you do so, you can do all these things based on it. Okay. So when you're creating a rapid prototype, when you're creating any prototypes, it can be a component, anything. So when you do that, mostly that will be a product. It will not be a single component. It will be a product. Once you do that, you also need to do interference detection check. You need to know how much interference it is having. Because if it is having still a lot of interference, when you do 3D printing, there will be overlap. Okay, materials will be created on top of materials. So there will be overlap. It needs to be avoided. And also when you're dealing with assemblies like this, you need to provide proper scaling for all the materials. Depends upon it. So probably you might have come to know all these things when you're going for presentations of those things. So with that, I've explained all the things that is required for the assembly. If you have any queries, let me know in the chat. I will explain the answers to that. Otherwise, we will move on to how you can export these components to 3D printing STL files. Let me show you how you can save it, everything. Okay. So if you have any queries on part design and assembly, I'll take now for 1 or 2 minutes. Then we'll move on to exporting the components into different file formats.
Sir, can we duplicate the assembly?
Sir, your voice is breaking, sir. I'm not able to hear it clearly. Can you...
Sir, can we duplicate the assembly, like in x-axis and y-axis, if we want to screw n number of screws, can we duplicate it?
Yeah, sure. It can be done. It can okay, be sir. Done. Linear component.
What's the, may you know the option for it?
Okay. Linear component pattern. That's what I'm trying to do right now. Let me show you this. So if you want to in x direction or y direction, whatever the component it may be, you can select all the things. You can create number of duplicates in a particular direction. So if you want to do it in the other direction also, linear pattern, you can do the linear pattern here itself. Can create single number or multiple numbers of components. Okay, if there is no questions, I will move on to the exporting file formats. If you have any more questions and we have a time until 1 o'clock, you can always put it on the chat box or you can ask me directly. So let me show you how you can save this or export it into different file formats. The one easiest way is that file, save. Go for save as. So you can select STL file format or 3MF, AMF. Here you can see all three file formats are available here. STL, 3MF, EIMF, all these three things will be here. You can select any one of them. STL, 3D manufacturing file format, 3MF, additive manufacturing file format, AMF. Okay, the difference between these file formats also, let me explain. STL is actually standard tessellation language. It actually creates the 3D model into triangles. Okay. It will not store any other data such as color of the component, as well as material property of the component, whatever the thickness properties, those kind of things will not be saved in STL file format. When you're going for additive manufacturing, there are different type of printing style is there, like FDM. FDM is actually fused deposition modeling where you will melt the plastic and create the component. But whereas in SLA, it will be based on the resins, right? So each things will have different properties that are needed. For FDM, you need to provide proper material property. So that only the machine will create that much heat in order to melt it. Say if you are using a ABS, it is having melting point of 1050 degrees Celsius. If you provide accidentally nylon or something else, it will have different melting point, okay? So if it is having that melting point, it will not properly melt this, or it will melt overly. So likewise, it needs to be properly given for each and every type. So material is required, how much thickness, okay. For FDM, there is a minimum thickness 0.4 mm is the minimum nozzle size that is available right now commercially. But when you're going for SLAs, those kind of things, you can do even reduced that. 0.1 and 0.05, because it is based on resins only. So the fineness will be very accurate when you're going for SLA. So providing those kind of informations can also be given through SolidWorks, but that cannot be saved in STL file format. Okay. There are some printers such as Statasys Object Connect, I think, Object Connect print. It is having a PolyJet. Okay, you can print a flexible material as well as in a different colors. So when you're going for those kind of things, these display structures, those things will not be able to store in a STL file format. For that only, we are having 3D manufacturing file format, .3MF, .AMF. These two file formats will carry both the thickness value, material property, whatever you are providing, everything will be given here. And also, of course, we are having a lot of softwares, pre-processing softwares. Okay, before the printing, we have Cura, we have a preform. Okay, these are all the software that is used for 3D printers in order to create the path lines. Okay, when you are going for a when you are inserting this STL file into Cura, the Cura will slice the component into number of layers and it will give it all these data to the printer. Okay, but with help of SolidWorks, if it is a simple component which does not require any support and all, you can directly print it using SolidWorks. You don't need a Cura at all or any other preform softwares at all. You can just connect your printer directly to this particular laptop, and you can provide all these things. In FDM, there is a question asking in terms of 3MF, AMF. That's what I explained. In STL, there won't be any datas. In 3MF, AMF, these datas along with the graphical data, they both will be stored. Okay, thickness value as well as material property value, everything can be stored in this 3MF and AMF. You can directly use this to print. So you can select the STL file. And most of you might have heard about this STL. STL is the best thing for a printer. So how does STL will look like? When you open a STL file, how does it look? Okay, so when you save this, you can see that. See, this is how the STL file will looks like. It will be a triangular file. Okay, here you can see. Here you can see the components is converted into number of triangles, smaller triangles. Okay, this is how the STL file will looks like. When you export it as a STL, this is how it looks. So let me give as the STL file will be saved. Most of you dealt with some FEA softwares also. In the FEA softwares such as ANSYS or ANSA, IPMesh, Fluent, in those kind of softwares, we'll be having mesh. Okay, STL is kind of mesh only. We used to do mesh in those kind of softwares. STL is kind of mesh only. Okay, so hope this is clear up to now. So either you can save it as a AMF, 3MF, or you can save it as a STL file. So let me open the file, whatever I saved. This was, so it is in the machine wise. Let me open it. So here you can see STL. So when you're using a Windows 10, you don't need any special software to give the STL file format. If you are using a Windows 10, you can use this 3D builder. You can just double click the STL file and you can see it. Okay, if you are using Windows 7 and Windows other versions, so it won't be possible. From Windows 10, you can see the STL file just like that. You can see it. You don't need any special type of softwares. And there is a question asking me, is it possible to edit STL file? Yes, of course it is possible to edit STL file. It is possible in SolidWorks. Again, you can import that. So let me close this. File open. So you can open this directly. So this is how it looks like. It is a graphical window. Okay, everything is actually
sorry sir, Kavi sir. Sir, can you convert this file into the 3DMF or AMF? We want to see how it looks like.
Sir. Yes, sir. I will save it as a DMF, AMF. For visual properties, it is going to have the same. Let me show you. So let me provide some properties and I will tell you. So as I told you, if you are having Windows 10, you can directly print that. So file, print 3D, go for print 3D. Here you can set up your print printer size. Okay. So basically it is having 254, 271 depth and the height is 177. So I select this face, it will show me the print area. Okay, this is the print area. This is my base. So you can scale to fit properly, or else if it is too big, you can scale to fit. This is proper size, proper, yeah, everything is properly. And you can provide infill percentage, whether it is 40%, whether it is 70% or 100%, you can provide all these things. When you are working with the mechanical components, when you're dealing with, if you're creating a component that is going to be under some stress, then you have to print the component with 100%. If you're printing a component for aesthetic purposes, for just a show purposes, then you can print it for 40% or 70%. But when it comes to mechanical property, mechanical component, kindly print it on the 100% so that it will have a better strength, okay? So you can provide all these infill percentages. For now, I will go with infill percentage. If you need any support, you can provide include support. Go for the preview and you can see, you can provide the layer height here. Okay, you can provide layer height. So when I provide the layer height, you can see the striation lines. You can see here, depend upon the layer height, you can see the striation height. So these are all the informations that will be saved in 3MF and AMF. For visual properties, visually, this is going to have triangles only, okay, in 3MF and AMF also. But it also has these things, layer height, as well as here you can see material, okay. So material selection, those things can be given here. So if it is required any, here you can see if any phases is required support, that will be shown in a green color face. These phases required support. Okay. So when you are having a supports only, you need help of Cura software as well as preform software. Because when you go for those kind of softwares, that also generates the support and you can view the support in this, in those software itself. Cura or preform. So here you can select different kind of materials as I showed you. So someone asked me, what is the difference in STL and 3MF, AMF? Here, the material data, striation lines, these things can also be given here itself. And then you can save it as 3MF and AIMF.
Sir, can you zoom that material section?
Can you zoom? Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
In recent versions, this is 2018 that I'm using. I actually planned for 2020 in order to showcase the there are a lot of developments in 2020 SolidWorks. We have different type of printers and we also have a lot of developments in 2020. I wanted to show you that, but due to some technical issues, I was not able to use that laptop. So in this 2018, we are having these things. In 2020, we also have different type of printers. Whatever the printers that are available right now in the commercial market, you can find all those printers inside the SolidWorks itself. You can set up. You don't have to enter every time your printer size. You will be having all the data gathered by the database. Okay. So all these things will be available.
Say like SolidWorks is like SolidWorks 2020 is like a design to prototype, a combo?
Yes sir. You can do print, you can select the material sizes, material type, the thickness layer, and also the printing machine sizes. Everything is here. Okay, you can design as well as you can use it for prototyping also.
Thank you sir.
So here I'm going for 3MF and AMF. This print, this file read by only the machines. So if it is a STL file, it can be read by the 3D builder option in the Windows 10, but this is 3MF and AMF. This cannot be read in a these tool. This you can insert in the machine. That machine will recognize the amount of the component as well as the material properties and the thickness, etc. Okay. So just save all these three things will also be saved inside of it. Okay. If you need a raft, you can insert the raft. Raft is a baseline, base area. When you start to print a component, before immediately start printing the component, it will create a base raft for 1mm or 2mm. Those raft will be removed after the printing. Okay, so if you want raft, you can insert the raft. So you can create, or you can save it using 3mm and AMF. So there is another thing. Saving a part as a STL file is different from saving an assembly as a STL file. Please always remember, saving an assembly as a STL file is different actually. Let me show you how it is different. In this, I have two identical components. I can save both spring and the bot. If I save them separately and I can ask it, this particular component is not going to be a problem. But when it comes to machinized assembly that I showed you, it is having of a component that is that needs to be properly fixed, assembled, right? So let me show you. And machine wise, so let me remove this linear pattern. So here we are having different size of components. So when you save this, nearly 6 components are there. File, save as, or you can go for print also, STL file. In the STL file, you have an option. Go for the options. The option, either you can save the entire assembly as a single file, or else you can save the entire assembly as a different files. Okay, you can use either you want to save it in a millimeters, centimeters, or meters. The component may be, when you're designing, the component may be in a micrometer. Okay, so if you're dealing with the nano size robots, you can design that in nano size, but when you are trying to create a model, not prototype, then you want to show model, the view of for presentation purposes, okay, not working prototype. When you want to show something in a model presentation purposes, you can enable, you can just scale it, right? So likewise, you can scale it on different sizes, millimeter, or else if you want to scale it on your terms, you can do in a printing. So you can select that. You here you can see save all the components of an assembly in a single file. If you enable this, it will have only a single file, machine wise assembly STL alone. Everything will be saved as a single file. But when you save this as a different file format, here you can see it is saved as a single file. But when you save this, let me save it once again, file, save as STL file, options, go for, instead of millimeters, I'm going for inches to showcase that it is considering that. Let me take this, save all the components in a single file. Instead of saving it as a single file, I'm saving it as a multiple files, individual files. Each one of these file will be saved as a different files. So here you can see, previously I had only machine STL. Now I can machine is part one, part two, part three. So when I open it, everything will be opened. Here you can see. So it is in the inches, you can see it with the proper dimensions. When I return open this, everything will be inches, because I when I save it inches, it will be scaled, okay, with respect to the inch. Hope this is clear,
sir.
You can see each of this is different STL file. Yes, sir.
So last question, as you shown in a STL file setting,
yes, sir.
Can we set the angle parameters
For components?
Yeah, for
it needs to be 35 degree position to 40 degree.
Yeah.
Yes, sir, that can be done in the printers.
Okay.
Print 3D. Here you can select this face. Here you can see it is bigger. You can use scale to fit. And also you can use orient to fit.
Okay.
You can see it is not straight. You can provide this angle. If you want to rotate this, you can use this. You can use.
Sir, I'm asking about the raster angle. Printing raster angle.
Rotating the component. Yeah. So you can, in this, if it is rotated, say for example, if I'm selecting some other faces, angled face. Go for the print. Print D. You can select this face. So likewise, you need a reference. Reference, go for the scale to fit and move it upward. You can use these kind of reference faces to rotate the geometry. Okay. But if you want to reduce the amount of material that is required to create the draft, because sometimes when you are creating support, If you place it in a 0 degree, it may require a lot of support. If you place it 30 degree, it may require less material, less support. In order to find that optimization, we have to go with the pre-processing software such as Cura and Preform. Using that only, you can do that. With SolidWorks, if you have reference faces, using that, you can rotate like this. But when you do this, you're actually going to need a lot of supporting like this faces. Those are the face that requires support. Okay, so support structures needs to be created. Not in SolidWorks, it will be created in the machine directly. So anything else, sir? Any doubts?
No, thank you.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, if I want to add two holes for the fixture of the vise, can I make it in the .stl file?
I don't get you. You want to add holes?
Holes in the vise. Can I do it in .stl file itself? I want to add two holes at the base, sir.
No. Yeah, but that you have to do it in the SolidWorks, then you have to convert into STL file format.
Sir.
Once you have converted the STL file format,
okay, sir.
You're not able to edit it. Okay. In other softwares, again, you have to import it into SolidWorks. You have to convert that into solid geometry, then you have to do edit. It is better to do that in the 3D model, then convert it as STL. STL is your final result. Sometimes, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir, I can understand, sir. Is there any special softwares to edit that STL files?
Sir, STL file can be...
Yeah, you can edit it in SolidWorks. That's what I'm trying to say. You can edit the STL file in SolidWorks. What I'm saying is that, if you are trying to edit an STL file in SolidWorks, again, you have to convert that STL into solid model, geometry. STL is not a geometry. STL is a graphics file. It will have only outer graphics. That is enough for a machine to create outer line paths. Okay. So that is why we are converting that into STL. But it can be edited in SolidWorks also. And also, we have other softwares such as Magic Shapes and some softwares are there, Blender. Some softwares are there you can use to edit the STL, but those softwares also has the same thing. It will convert that STL into mesh geometry. Using that mesh geometry only, you will be able to edit it. Mesh mixture, Magic Shapes, and Blender. These are the software that I know you can edit the STL as well as SolidWorks. Sometimes we will be scanning the file, right? Will not be generating the 3D file, we'll be scanning the file. We use the 3D scanners to scan. Say, for example, if you are working with architectural, now we are preserving our old temples. Now, most of areas where they are having old temples, more than 2,000, 3,000 year old, they are trying to preserve the entire structure by 3D scanning. Okay. If they want to create a 3D model, what they do is they'll just scale the entire model, scan it and scale it. If they want to do some modifications on top of that, they can convert the STL file into a solid file in SolidWorks. Then they can do the modifications. But in order to add holes and those simple operations, it is better to create it in a 3D model and do it. Hope it was clear.
Sir. Can we open the AutoCAD file, two-dimensional AutoCAD file in the SolidWorks?
Yes, sir, it is possible. You can open 2D DWG file format in SolidWorks.
Is it vice versa? Can we do?
If you want to open
SolidWorks.
Yeah, DWG file can be exported as well as imported in SolidWorks. If you do the drawing in AutoCAD, you can import the DWG format into the SolidWorks. If you create a drawing in SolidWorks, you can export it as a DWG file and you can open it in AutoCAD. They both are possible.
Okay. Means,
sir, STL file can be... STL file can be...
Sir,
sir,
yes, sir.
STL file can be, STL file can be imported to ANSYS or other kind of finite element software.
Yes, it is possible in ANSYS. It is possible right now. From ANSYS 2018, there is something called a Space Climb. Space Climb is another designing software in ANSYS. Previously, there was a design modeler. It is still there. But it is possible to import these STL files into ANSYS. You can use Space Climb to insert, and then you can convert that.
But sometimes sometimes it creates problem while we are imported STL file and creating meshing. So yes, it sometimes creates problem. Actually, meshing is not done in ANSYS.
Okay, we need to check the geometry. That there could be some errors because when you're converting it as a STL file, it is actually approximating the entire section. When we do mesh, what we do, it is going to be approximation of the outer shape. It is same like meshing. In meshing, the component entire body will be saved as a mesh. But here in STL, the outer shape will be saved as a mesh. So it is going to have some problem, but still that can be rectified using Space Climb. Space Climb has some tools. Yeah, Space Climb has the tools to rectify those things.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Or else you can also import into the SolidWorks and you can convert that as a STL file. Let me show you that also. So many of you asked me. Let me show you just 1 minute to explain that. Yes, here it is, mesh file, STL. So you can select the part, open it. Here it will be imported geometry that can be converted into mesh body. Like a solid body. Here you can see it is a solid body right now. Previously it was not a solid body. Here it is, now it is a solid body. Can you see this? It was imported using STL. Now you will be able to edit things using this. In 2020, these things has been improved. Yeah, let me show you. When you import an STL file, open. When you import an STL, choose your file format as mesh file. Let me zoom in a bit. So hope this is clear now. Mesh, OBJ, OFF, PLY. These are the different file formats that can be obtained from the 3D scanners. Okay, 3D scanners has a capability of obtaining not just the geometry, it also obtains the color as well as the textures of the component. We have that much effective 3D scanners right now. So that can be exported as a OBJ. You can use that, or else you can use the conventional STL file. You can select this option, then go for the part, open it. When you open it, it will be a graphical file. It will not be a solid file. There is a difference between and a graphical body. Remember this, there is a difference between a graphics body as well as solid body. This is a graphics body. How can I say this? When you split this, you can see there is an error. It is showing me that it is just a graphics body. It doesn't have any part like point, line as a geometrical data. It doesn't have any geometrical data, only graphical data, visual data. Okay. When you have a geometrical data, point, line, face, surface only, you'll be able to split the component. So now when I try to convert this as a body, right click, go for convert to mesh body, also called the BREP bodies, boundary representation bodies. Select this, go for group faces, just give OK. That will be converted into solid body. When I try to this, here you can see, I have both graphics body as well as solid body in the same area. That is why I'm getting the error. Here you can see it is I'm able to split the component into half. And if you want to see this as edges, you can see it. See, You can see the edges, points, lines, faces. If it is a graphic body, you cannot, you will not be able to see these things like this. So hope you understand this. No, there is a question asking me if whether all the STL files are printable. Yes, sir, it is printable. And as I explained to you before, when you have a STL file, the printers will recognize the outer structure. Okay. Sometimes when you scan, not when you create a body, when you save it as a STL file, when you scan a body, if you scan black bodies, black color bodies, you will have a problem. There will be errors in the scanning file. Okay. When you have those kind of STL files, still it is printable, but there will be errors. There will be avoids. Okay. So it is better to check in the preform softwares, Cura or preform softwares, pre-processing softwares. And there you can find if you have any openings or if you have any misalignments or any misshape, you can find those things in those softwares, or else you can open it in SolidWorks. You can find those errors and you can modify it in SolidWorks, but you cannot modify it in Preform or Cura software. Cura softwares and Preform is not for modification. It's only for to recognize, to create structures, nothing else. So this clarifies your doubts, sir. And last thing, most of you ask me, where can I get the manual? How do we learn these things? Let me show you. Yes. When you're, there is a question asking me, how can you control the mesh in a different area of the body? When you export this, you save file, save as. When you go for STL file format, you'll be having an option to control that. But this is also up to certain level. If it is a flat face, just like this, if it is a flat face, surely the triangles will be very bigger. That's because that's how the software is generated. Okay, because they don't want to create the file size higher. The more the triangle, the file size will be very higher. Okay, dealing with that file size will be very, very difficult. But if you want to do that in ANSYS, sorry, in SolidWorks, we also have a capability of doing a mesh. Okay, using that mesh, you can mesh the entire geometry just like we will do in FEA software. Then you can export it as a cloud point files or STL file. That can be done. But if you need some little control here, you can do find course. You can select that. You can set your millimeters. If it is custom, you can provide the tolerance level. Okay, and just give okay. So these are the settings that you can use to do it. You can see how much triangles, how much file size it is going to be. You can use this and you can see number of triangles, etc. So there is a website called MySolidWorks. It is a SolidWorks official website where you can log in. MySolidWorks, kindly note this. MySolidWorks is an official SolidWorks training website where you can create your own login. Okay. You don't have to pay. It has a different access. The first level of access is for guest. Anybody can log in. Okay. It's like creating an account in LinkedIn or Twitter or Facebook. You can create an account in it. In that, you'll be having a bus. You can showcase your CAD model, trainings, So you can do all this thing in the training. You can search for tutorials. Okay, e-courses, learning path, everything will be available here. Lessons are individual videos depending upon the topic you are choosing. If you want to learn sketch, you can type sketch. You can go through the videos one by one. Okay, there will be a tutor who will be teaching. Everything is recorded session. You can see nearly 150 videos are available for guests. If you sell, you can see through all these dates. You can use these filters. So sketch creating, starting a sketch on interface. Just select this whole wizard, converting entities, whatever I explained, most of the things will be here. You can just select and you can see. So you can open it in SolidWorks, or you can open even in a phone also. This page can be opened in a phone. You can start studying these things. Surely this will be very helpful. You can go through this. And if you have any more queries in future, you can always contact us also. I'll share you my details. So.
Sir, can we practice online on that platform? Can we practice this 3D modeling?
Yes, sir. It is possible to.
Hello.
Yes, sir. It is possible in a My SolidWorks environment. Okay. Just now I showed you the website, yes, right? Yes, it is possible.
That is without.
There you have option called Try SolidWorks.
Okay.
You don't have to install the software on that website. Right, you can try SolidWorks, but that is only for a certain period. Actually, it is for online trial purposes. Those who want to see how the software works and how different things are works, for that only it is there. So daily 2 hours you can work for 1 week, I think. So after that, you will not have to work. If you need any more queries or any more things regarding that, you can always contact me. This is me, Kavi Pradap, application engineer, and that's my number and my email ID is there, and others are my colleagues.
Excuse me, sir. We can't see the screen, sir.
Specialized. Yes, ma'am.
Sir, we can't see the screen, sir.
I think it is. What about others? Does anybody has the
Kavi sir screen? Terila, sir. Sir, screen visibility illa.
Yes, sir. We have the information from participants, right, sir.
Yes, sir. I'll try to show again. Just a...
It is visible, sir.
Is it visible now?
Yeah, participants, please use pin option for seeing the screen.
That is visible, ma'am.
Yeah.
Hello.
So this is my Kavi Pradap, and you can see. Yes, yeah, sir.
Hello. Hello.
The website address, I will type the website.
Hello, yes, sir. Hello, sir. Just yes, one sir. Question, sir. Is it possible to print the entire assembly in the printer, entire assembly, which can differentiate, which have number of parts, so that those parts can be differentiated in the printer itself? Is it possible?
Yes, sir. It can be printed. Yes, it is possible, but we need to define that individual body. When we are saving, it will be as an individual body. In the preform software, we have to define that as individual body. Then between those components, if there is a clearance, we need to create a support material. The printer also needs to have the type of support. Okay, so we have two type of nozzles. One is for a material, one is for the support. When you have those kind of things, it is possible. It can be printed as a single assembly. It is possible.
Assembly with the different parts. So those parts can also be detached and just like that.
Sometimes when you are printing it as a single assembly, we'll be connecting it as a single part, right? So detaching it will be difficult. It depends upon the design.
Okay.
If you are designing, able to detach it, it will be. But it depends upon the design, how we are connecting. If you are creating a joint, completely you are holding it using plastic component, that cannot be breaked, cannot be detached because it's completely jointed, right? Like a chain link. Be difficult, but if you are designing in a side, it will be detached. Surely can be detached. It depends on the design, but also it is possible to print it as an entire assembly, a single shot. It is possible.
Okay, so okay, thank you.
And also for others, I have entered the website address in the chat box, www.mysolidworks.com. It is a SolidWorks official website where you can find training videos and also a lot of models that will be there. You can make use of that, as well as try SolidWorks option will also be there. And if you have any more queries regarding SolidWorks, you can always contact us. I've shown you my entire team's numbers and email IDs. You can always mail to us. Okay, thank you for the opportunity. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Ma'am, if you have anything to add.
I would like to thank on behalf of management and institution to our chief guest, Kavi Prakash, sir. Sir, it is a wonderful and informative hands-on training using SolidWorks. So it is a very informative session.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you all for the active participation, and participants, you can rejoin for next section at 2 p.m. Thank you all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Participants, kindly check the feedback link. It is available on the website, WhatsApp, and also in the meeting. Please see the feedback link.